Hi guys, we are continuing with our day 9 of InfyTQ assignments for the first module, that is Programming Fundamentals with Python. And today, and we are going to solve the third problem of day 9. So let's get into the question here. So what we have to do, we have to write a Python function to check whether a given number is perfect or not. The function should return true if the number is perfect, else it should return false. So what is a perfect number? Perfect number is a positive whole number that is equal to the sum of its proper divisors. And the perfect number, the first perfect number, for example, is 6. As it is equal to the sum of its proper divisor 1, 2 and 3, which adds up to 6. So 6 is the first perfect number. The other perfect numbers are 28, 496 and 8128. So let's just start this, and as you can see, we have also write an extension to the program where we are providing a list of numbers, and we are returning the lists of those numbers only which are perfect. Otherwise, we would be just returning an empty list. We would be getting to this particular section of the problem later. First, let's solve where we are providing a particular number and we have to check whether it is perfect or not. So what we have to do basically, we have to find out the list of the divisors of a particular number, and if the sum of that list is equal to the number, then it is a perfect number. So first, what we have to do, let's go to our PyCharm and first create a Python file as problem 43 and first create a function as get underscore divisors. So these are basically the proper divisors of a number, and we are passing n, and this would be returning a list of the divisors of that particular number. So what we have to do for I in range, we have to specify from 1 to n. So proper divisors only include till n minus 1. So if there are any numbers which are divisors till n minus 1, we would be including them, and so we can pass the range from 1 to n, that is it will go from 1 to n minus 1. If n mod I is equal to 0, that is n is divisible by I, we have to append it to our list, so l dot append I. Otherwise, we will not append, and at the end of the loop, we would be just returning the particular list. So return l, and this would be the list of the divisors of a particular number. So now what we have to do, we have to find out whether a number is perfect or not. So this is time for the second function. So the second function is def is underscore perfect. That also takes in a number. And what we would do, we would be just checking if the sum of the return value from get underscore divisors of the particular number n is equal to n, then it is a perfect number. So we would be returning true, else we would be returning false. So def is underscore perfect is done. Let's just check whether 6 is a perfect number or not. Means if what according to the test case, it should come out as true. Let's just run it. It is problem number 43. Let's run our problem number 43. It returns true. Let's take in for a bigger value, that is 8128. So 8128. Let's run our code. It is also returning true. And suppose I pass 8129, it should return false because it is not a perfect number. So this is for the first part of the program. So now we have to code for the extension. In the extension, we are provided a list of numbers and we have to find out the perfect number from a given list of numbers. So def, let the function name be check underscore perfect underscore numbers, and we are providing a list here as a parameter. So let's create an empty list as perfect underscore numbers. it's an empty list for I in L, that is for each element in the list L, if isPerfect is true, isPerfect of I is true, then we have to append it to our perfect numbers dot append I, and at the end we would be returning perfect underscore numbers, return perfect underscore numbers. So this is it, and we would be returning perfect underscore numbers, and we would be seeing the only those numbers which are perfect, and if there are no numbers that are perfect, we would be just returning an empty list. So check underscore perfect underscore numbers. What I would be doing, I would be placing these values 28, 496 and 8128. This would be a list, I guess. Yeah, this would be a list, and along with them I would be passing 1, I would be passing 100, I would be passing 1000. Okay, let's run our code. So you're getting 28, 496 and 8128, those which are perfect numbers already. So we have successfully written a program where we are passing the list of numbers and we are getting the return as the list of the numbers which are only perfect. But behind the code, we have done many things. As you have seen, we have fetched the divisors of a particular number. We have checked whether it is perfect or not. And we have checked it, done this multiple times for each element in the list. So thanks for watching this video, guys. I hope so you understood this particular solution. And see you in the next one.